Hello and welcome back again to my little show. My name is Carsten Petersen, and by this recently I've done some the Mars Volta reactions, and all of them are first reactions because the band is new in my world, and I am digging the hell out of it, if you can say that. And it's really cool. I hope you've seen the previous videos, because this is the third concerning the album Amperfecture. Yeah. So you need to see, maybe you need to see, if you want to see the whole reaction to the whole album, you need to see the first two videos. That's it, man. But so this is the final one, and concerning this, and I'm all stoked about it. Yeah, I don't know why I hold it up to my chin. Maybe I need to take a slow dance with this album. It's like, it's you and me now, baby. We need this. Yes. I've been looking for you all my life. No, that's silly. But anywho, yeah, you see, I can't get it off my face. I need to listen to the three last tracks ASAP, pronto, like you know, right now. All kidding aside, it's true, it's stock. But yeah, take it off your face, man. But why not do this? So are you ready to listen to the final tracks? I certainly am. My head has been blown to pieces over this group and this album so far. It already started with the Francis the Mute album review. That was the starter. That was the, oh my god, you can leave your expectations, what do you call it, expectations at the door. You know, you can leave what you know at the door, because we're gonna fuck your music brain up. We're gonna do shit to it nobody has thought about yet. Yeah, they're taking concept album to, I would say, another level, and at the same time deconstructing it. So and I had a lot of thought about that during the night between the two videos, and my thought was that concept albums is maybe the oldest album genre in the world. We just forgot about it. Think about Beethoven and, you know, all that. It's a whole album, the whole deal. It's a, you know, you have the four acts. It's not like in an album format. Album is we call it album because I think it's like, you know, looking at a family album, for example, and there's no thin red line going all through it, you know. It's just like random times and moments in time. Times and moment. But and that would be your usual pop album, like a Beatles album, not the white one, but the earlier ones. And I guess most pop albums. But classic music has always been like, you know, like a piece. So I guess we can call it a piece. It's a piece of art. That being said, where were we at? This is the end of the previous track, so we are slowly but easy moving on to, oh, it started. Yeah. No. There's no pause, there's no silent bit. It all flows, just like in you. The fuck is happening? What? Sorry. I was about to say, you really think sometimes that something is wrong with you? With your speaker, you know? Most badass I've heard yet. That's badass. We'll be right back. Did you see that? Just 5, 5, 5. Very easy. I am loving the hell out of the drumming. The drumming is some of the best drumming I ever heard. Period. It's so organic, so jazzy, so unconventional, you know. Just listen. It's beautiful. The whole thing is beautiful. Don't get me wrong. This is just going back to Santana, you know. Santana-ish. Yeah, you know what? You know what, man? Got the key. Fucking shit. This would be a good place to put in some. I'm gonna pause it. The next is just about to start and I have some thought about it. Why is it that somebody told a story about a guy at the comment section? His friend thought it was a female. He said, "Who's the female singing, you know?" And that is a problem. I would think a lot of people has thought wrong about what they're listening at, about, you know, concerning gender or even color. You know, Elvis Presley, a lot of people thought he was black. I thought Eminem was black. The first time I heard Eminem, you know, the real Slim Shady, I'll have to admit, I saw Chris Rock in my head during the radio, you know, listen. So yeah, I was pretty dumbstruck. And oh, it's white, it's a white dude. Oh yeah, he hates his mother. Poor him. La-di-da. But I had a thought about it. Why is it when male singers are going high like you would, you know, connect to a female singer, just when you're thinking traditionally, you know, old school, they all a lot of them, the males, they're going higher, just like the drag queen. He or she, he's not doing just like a female. He's doing female on crack. And you can say that also to the singers, you know. He's doing a female, but on crack. Maybe it's a kabuki thing. Maybe it's just like in the, you know, like, you don't think about it. You have to exaggerate. Oh yeah, one more thing. The next one just started. Oh, it's a long one too, man. So far, the last track, I'll have to say that's the one for me. That is the top tippy top of the album so far. The album is the fucking shit, you know. The bee's knees, you know, a cat's pajamas, what do you call it? But the sixth track, that was smooth, that was funky, that was badass. And now we're going back to Cuba, baby. Forget about it. It's like Scarface, you know. Scarface in a Cadillac. Forget about it. You're calling me crazy? You're calling me loco? Say hello to my little friend. I think it's high enough. I knew it. Sometimes I knew. I had a feeling. To say high pitch. Oh my god. Keep poof. The sound he just made, I don't think you're gonna hear it through this setup, but if you never heard this on a real good, you know, set of speakers, you should. That was insane. Somehow I got the feeling that if track 6 was Kansas, we are not there anymore. This sounds more like, you know, pulling it apart again. There was no pulling, nothing anywhere apart over the sixer. That was the big surprise about it. Maybe it tells a lot about me where I am right now in my Mars Volta trip. I did go for the most conventional. Shame on me. This rhythm, this melody, huh? to the spaceship, man. Cinematic. We're going straight from Jesus Christ Superstar to Flash Gordon. It's a video drone. Fucking hell. Russian twist. the Holocaust. Or Ilsef, the wicked warden. So the last just started 2 seconds in. That was mind blowing. Does not cover it because we are used to use that word for when it's, you know, mind-blowing. This was mind-blowing. This was not mind-blowing. Blowing, mind-blowing. Poof, poof, and then puff. And then when you thought you just had the last puff, now here comes another poof. I really don't know what to say right now. I think we're just gonna listen to the rest and then I have to think about what I have to say, because this is the shit, man. That was a lesson. I just got schooled. I feel like I've been naughty. It's like, no, you don't know what music is. This is what it's supposed to sound like. You know what I mean? When it's out of the box. You never heard out of the box before you heard the Mars Volta, I guess. That's not too much, sir. you say it. Much going on. It's not bad, but it's clearly not the best of the album. I don't think they're gonna hit us with some, you know, big tune right now. So you can use this track to get down on earth again, maybe. That is, if they're holding it together. The last minute or so. But yeah. 76 minutes album total, and it just like boop, again, no fading out, it's just like pressing stop on a recorder. And that's the Mars Volta way. I learned that by now. Yeah, they can do that. Yeah, I still don't know what to say, I had to admit. So if no, I don't. I could add that it, when you're listening to it first time, the whole album. Now I've done it in parts, and I've done, you know, like repetitively heard the first one again and again and again before I did the second video. Then I heard that so, several times. So I really chewed through this album, and yeah, it's an interesting way of closing it with a 9 minute track almost with no pizzazz at all. That reminded me of some, you know, slowly slodgy drone rock, like Melvins would do it back in the days, where you heard that, and then, and all of a sudden they would go after 14 minutes. Then you'll have the drums kicking it, and the guitar would go on a very grungy riff, you know, the type of some of you know it, Melvins fans do. So oddly enough, it reminded me of Melvins you know, deal, the latter part. And but yes, in short, if we have to cook it down, holy crap, that was a very, very cool album. That is not that doesn't sound so you know, official, but what else can we say about this? What else can I say about this then? This is the cat's pajamas. This is the bee's knees for sure. And from now on, simply, the Mars Volta will forever be in my favorite group, you know, department, what do you call it? I would put them right up there with the greatest in modern rock, you know, like with the, who can we put them up against? Up besides Hachuchuhach, Kasu Junri, you know, from the newer days. Yeah. Not many, no, not many bands will deliver this amount of quality. At the same time, it's very rare, and damn it, I have to buy every single album they done, because that's what I do when I find something I really love. And this, yeah, now I know it. I really, what to say in short, I really love the Mars Volta. Keep it simple. Yeah. You know I love you, and Chi-Chi says hello. She's sleeping. I think it was the last tune. It was like, is it 10 o'clock already? She was like going back and front, you know, like setting the alarm clock. I don't know. So it had some effect. And as I said, you know I love you. Have a great weekend, and I will be back with some more fantastic subjects, videos, hopefully fantastic, but yeah, you know it. You know where I'm at. Bye now.